Welcome to Science Tour online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students. So we were discussing about connected body problem, and we have discussed several types of or way of connecting of a body. So in today's class, what are we going to discuss is, consider a body or consider a body of Marsium, and it is lifted by certain amount of force. In a previous case also we have discussed, but there we were not lifting the object in upward direction, but here we are lifting the object in upward direction by applying a external force. So when the object is lifted, right, object will be accelerating in the same direction of applied force. Now what is the acceleration of this body? Let's take the free body diagram, let's draw it. The forces acting on this Marsium is, one is external force, another one is weight of it, that is m into g, and body is accelerating in the direction of applied force. Now what is the net force acting on this body? The net force is external force minus weight. Why external force minus weight? Because external force is greater than the weight. So how it is greater? Because acceleration is in the direction of applied force, is equal to m into a. We are applying F is equal to ma formula. Here F is net force. Net force is F minus mg. F is applied force. Mg is the weight of the object under consideration. Now F is equal to m of a plus g. Am I correct? F is equal to m of a plus g. So this is the force, applied force. Now how do you find out acceleration? See, acceleration is force minus weight, mg can be written as weight, is equal to m into a. So force minus weight divided by mass is nothing but acceleration. So to be more clearer, let me consider two masses. Okay, m1, m2, and you apply force here, external force is applied here. Here tension is acting, correct? M1 and m2 are connected through a string, tension is acting, and whole system is lifted. So when it is lifted upward, accelerating is also upward. Body, whole system is accelerating in a upward direction. Now draw the free body diagram for this. M2. What is the free body diagram of M2? Tension upward and weight of it M2 into G. So tension acting on the string is M2 into G. Next, free body diagram of M1. It says that force upward and weight, tension plus weight M1 into G, or weight of M2 and weight of M1. That also you can say. M2 into G. So acceleration is upward, so this force is greater. Force minus M1 plus M2 into G is equal to M2 into A. M1 into A. This body is accelerating, so we can't apply this. Tension minus M2 into G is equal to M2 into A. So by solving this, if you solve this, if you go on with lot of process, and if you solve this, see here M1 into, if you, what is tension? Yeah, tension minus, here M2 into G can be written as tension, M1 into G plus tension. So by solving this, you will get an expression. So if you solve, if you subtract each other, then M2 into G minus force plus m1 into g is equal to m1 plus m2 into a. So m1 plus m2 into g minus force is equal to, so this will be minus, so minus m1 minus m2, m1 plus m2 into g, so into a will be F minus weights, or m1 plus m2. Why am I not doing such a well, students? So by applying Newton's second law here, F is equal to ma, F is equal to ma, acceleration is upward, so tension is greater. Tension minus m2 into g is equal to m2 into a. Okay. Now draw the free body diagram of m1. Upward is external force, downward is tension plus m1 into g. Correct? Tension plus m1 into g. Acceleration is upward. The forces acting on m1 is, one is tension downward, another one is external force upward, and weight of itself. So here upward force is greater, so F minus tension minus m1 into g is equal to m1 into a. You can add these two. When you add these two, tension gets cancelled. So F minus m1 into g minus m2 into g is equal, on the right hand side, m1 plus m2 of a. A is common on the right hand side. Okay. Here F minus m1 plus m2 into g is equal to m1 plus m2 into a. So what do you get as acceleration? F minus m1 plus m2 into g divided by m1 plus m2. So now the tension is equal to, so from this tension you know how to calculate, correct? By substituting any one of them you will get the tension. So this is the way. If you have three masses, how to do it? Again following the same method, m1, m2, m3, this is external force. But students, this is again tedious process. How will you do is, you will go with the simple formula. See, net force acting here. How much is the net force acting here? Force applied minus weight. Am I correct? Force applied minus weight. And then the method of finding acceleration is net force divided by, net force divided by total mass. So what is the total mass here? Total mass is equal to m. Then what is the acceleration? Net force by total mass. Net force is F minus W divided by m. So this is your acceleration, direct method. Same thing here, acceleration is equal to net force divided by total mass. Okay, summation of mass. What is the net force acting here, students? Net force is equal to applied external force minus total weight. What is total weight? M1 plus M2 into g. Net external force applied minus total weight, because applied external force is upward, acceleration of the whole system is also upward. Weight is acting downward. So acceleration is due to F minus weight. Okay. Then acceleration is equal to F minus M1 plus M2 into g divided by M1 plus M2. Can you write the same here? Acceleration is equal to, what is the net force here? The force applied, upward force minus total weight, M1, M2, M3. M1 plus M2 plus M3 into g divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3, when if the acceleration is upward. Same problem. Okay. M1, M2, M3. force is applied upward, but acceleration is downward. How will you write the acceleration? Acceleration is equal to weight. M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. So, weight minus force divided by total mass, summation of mass. So, this is how you have to write the direct formula for the acceleration. Tension, you know how to write the tension expressions, right? So, let's call this tension as T1, this tension as a T2. How will you get tension T1 and T2? Tension T1 is equal to M2 into A. Am I correct? Because this string, the distension is due only due to this mass. If this mass is not present, this tension wouldn't exist. Correct? That this rope, this is rope 2, this is rope 1. Rope 1 wouldn't get stretched. So, if M2 is 0, tension 1 will also be 0. M3. What about T2? T2 is exist only if these two masses are existing. So that means M2 plus M3 into A. M2 plus M3 into A. If any one of them not existing, still tension 2 will exist. If both of them don't exist, then this tension wouldn't exist because that string wouldn't get stretched. Correct? So M2 plus M3 into A. Correct? So this is the way of finding the tension. Now we will solve some of the problems related to this. Hello students, let's solve few problems under this connected body problem, whatever we have discussed in synopsis, right? So similar problems with the numericals, okay? Now, first one is, so for everything you should find out acceleration and the tension. You should find out acceleration and the tension. Now, what is the acceleration of this? You can go with the very long process, but we don't want that. We are applying for competitive examination. We should be able to do it within a minute. So how are we going with that? When you look at the problem itself, right, you should be able to derive the formula. You should be able to recall the formula. Okay. So how will you start with that? So I want acceleration. I know acceleration is net force divided by net mass. So when I say net force, total force, net mass, total mass. Okay, net mass. Okay. So see, mass is a scalar quantity. So when I say net mass, I meant total mass. That is 2 kg plus 3 kg plus 5 kg. Am I correct? But when I say net force, it is a vector quantity. Again, direction matters. 200 Newton is acting upward, weight of all these are acting downward. Correct? So net force is external force minus weight. Am I correct? So net force is external force minus weight. So my acceleration will be, what is the external force I have applied here? 200 Newton. And what is the weight of 2 kg? Let's consider G as a 9.10, not as a 9.8. So what is the total weight? 2 plus 3 plus 5 into 10. I am considering G as 10 meter per second square. Divided by, that is 10. 200 minus, this is 10, so 10 into 10 is 100. So 100 by 10 is equal to 10 meter per second square. So what is the acceleration of this whole system, students? 10 meter per second square. Don't have to do. So you can do 200 minus 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10. So 200 minus 10 into 10, that is 100, divided by total mass, that is 10. So you can directly do it, 10 meter per second. Now what is tension? What is T2? See, tension T2 exists only due to this mass. So you can say that phi into acceleration is T2. Am I correct? Phi is this mass. What is T1? T1 is exist due to the presence of both of the masses. So you can say 3 plus phi into acceleration. Tension is ultimately mass into acceleration. So for this tension, these two masses are present or required. So what will be this? 5 into 10 is 50 and 8 into 10 is 80. So 50 Newton and 80 Newtons are the tension. So I am sorry, T2 is 50 Newton, T1 is 80. Remember always, this string, right? This string, it should bear the weight of 3 kg and 5 kg. Whereas this string is just bearing the weight of 5 kg. Obviously, this tension should be less than this tension. So T2 is 50 Newton, T1 is 30 Newton. Okay? So can't you do it with the within seconds, right? You can do it within seconds. So are we getting a right answer? Just clear it. 10. Meter per second is the answer. That's correct. So let's move to the next problem. What is the acceleration? Again, acceleration is net force by net mass. What is the net force for the acceleration? One is weight of these two and weight of these two. These two are heavier than these two, correct? 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 into g minus, this is the weight of 2 kgs, 2 into g divided by total mass, that is 10. So G I take it as a 10. So 8 minus 2 is 6. 6 into 10 divided by 10. 6 meter per second square is the acceleration. Tension T2. What is the formula for T2 here? Imagine M1, M2 and M3 would have been the mass. Then T2 would be 2 into M1, M3 into G divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. Am I correct? If M3 doesn't exist, T2 wouldn't exist because this string wouldn't stretch. If M1 doesn't exist, still this string wouldn't stretch. Correct? So 2 into M1 M3 into G divided by M1 plus M2. So T2 will be how much? 2 into 5 into 10 divided by 20 Newton. Okay. What is T1? See, tension T1 is equal to 2 times of M1 into M2 plus M3 into G divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. How do I remember this formula? I am not by hurting this formula. See, there are two forces, so there are two mass. If M1 doesn't exist, T1 wouldn't have been there. If M2 doesn't exist, still would T1 will be there because this string will be stretched by M3. If M3 is not there, still T1 will be there because this string will be stretched by M2. But both of them are not there, then this string wouldn't get stretched, so T1 wouldn't exist. So M2 plus M3 into G. G means gravity divided by total mass. So 2 into 2, so this is 8 into 10 divided by 10. 10 gets cancelled. So this is 16. 16 into 2, 32 Newton. 32 Newton is the answer. Here, what is the acceleration? Net force divided by net mass. What is the net force responsible for acceleration, students? Obviously, 2m is greater than m. Therefore, acceleration will be downward. So weight of 2m is responsible for acceleration. So 2m is the net force acting on this whole system. Am I correct? Okay. Divided by total masses m plus 2m. So what is the acceleration? That is 2m divided by 3m, m gets cancelled. 2, yeah, 2 divided by 3 meter per second square. 2 divided by 3 meter per second square is your acceleration. Okay, and next, what is the tension? Tension here is this is tension. So tension, what is the formula for tension? If I take it as m1 and if I take this as m2, tension will be, there won't be tension if m1 wouldn't be there. If there is no m1, means this string wouldn't stretch. So m1 into m2, because if m2 is also not there, this string wouldn't stretch, into g divided by m1 plus m2. What is m1? M. What is m2? 2m into g divided by, so there should be one g here, correct? 2g by 3. Okay. Divided by m1 plus 2m. So this is 2m squared into g divided by 3m. M and m gets cancelled here. 2mg divided by 3 is the tension. Tension is 3 Newton. So well students, what I was telling you here is acceleration is net force. I had just taken 2m. 2m cannot be a force. 2m, it should be 2m into g. So then 2g, because 2m into g divided by 3m. So m gets cancelled. 2g divided by 3 is a meter per second squared is the acceleration. This is the tension. I hope you are following this. I am just doing it with the method, easy method, that is directly writing the formula. Writing the formula is little tricky, or it is little, it involves your smartness, but with the practice you can make it. So now here we have solved the problems like this. If this is m1, this is m2, what is the acceleration, students? Again, acceleration is net force. Net force divided by net mass. Okay, what is the net force acting here? One is weight of this m2 into g. Another one is y component of weight of this m1 into g sine theta. Theta is this. Okay, so what you can write, whether this is greater or this is greater, which is greater? Whether this weight will be greater or this weight will be greater. This is 3 kg, sorry, not 2 kg. They have not mentioned the direction of acceleration. So this is 3 kg and the other one is 2 kg. No, it should be reverse. This is 3 kg and this is 2 kg. How the system will accelerate? Whether it will accelerate towards 2 kg or 3 kg? If you calculate and see, m1 into g sine theta will be lesser than m2 into g. So acceleration is equal to m2 into g minus m1g sine theta divided by m1 plus m2. What is m2? The m2 is nothing but 2 kg. 2 into g is taken as 10, so 20 minus m1 is 3 kg, 3 into 10 is taken as 30 into sin theta, sin 30 degree. Sin 30 degree is 1 by 2. 2 ones are, 2 15s are. So divided by total mass, 3 kg plus 2 kg is 5 kg. So 20 minus 15 is 5 divided by 5, 1 meter per second square. But this is downward, so minus 1 meter per second square. It is retarding, students. Then how will you find out the tension? So what is the formula for the tension here? If you remember, tension, the tension here would exist only if this mass exists, so m2, and it would exist only if this mass exists, that is m1, and this angles exist, sine of this angles exist, so 1 plus sine theta, sine 30 degree into, or sine theta into g. If gravity exists, then only tension would exist, m1 plus m2. Substitute the value m1 into m2, that is 3 into 2, 3 into 2 is nothing but 6, and 1 plus sine 30 degree is 1 by 2 into 10 divided by 5. So this is 2 1s are 2 5s are 5 6 30, 30 divided by 5, this is half, right? Three by two, two ones are two fives are five, threes are 15. So, at the end, you should get the tension. Tension should be is equal to 18 newton. You should get 18 newton. M1 into M2 into 1 plus sin theta into G divided by 1 minus sin theta. Correct? 1 plus or 1 minus sin theta formula. It is 1 plus sin theta, 1 plus sin theta into G. So, you should get 18 newton, which is the tension acting on the string. So, this is how you should be solving the problem. Good morning, students. So, let's solve some of the problems related to the concept or a synopsis we have discussed in our previous class. So, let's in all the cases you should find out acceleration, and these are not really your NEET or CD questions, but similar kind of questions may appear. In all the cases you should find out acceleration and tension acting on the string. You should find out acceleration and tension acting on the string. So yes, we'll move to the first problem. First one, there are three masses which are hung and a force 200 newton is applied in upward direction, correct? This is the direction of force 200 newton. They are asking what is the acceleration and tension in the string. So let's call the tension here be T1 and tension here be T2, right? Okay, now what is acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but net force divided by net mass or total mass. Total mass. So you should remember this for all the problems. Net force divided by total mass. Okay. Then what is acceleration here? What is the total mass? Total mass is 5 plus 3 plus 2. Total 10 kg. 10 kg is the total mass. What is the net force, student? We have discussed in a synopsis. The net force here is nothing but, so acceleration is upward, am I right? So net force here is nothing but 200 newton, that is external force minus total weight of the system. How do we know it as acceleration is upward? If you calculate the total weight of this, what is the total weight of whole system? 5 plus 3, 8 plus 2, 10. So 10 kg, what is the weight of 10 kg? So 10 into 10, 100 newton is the weight of this whole system, but upward force is 200 newton. Obviously upward force is greater, so external force is greater means acceleration should also be in the direction of external force. So 200 minus 5 plus 3 plus 2 into 10, 10 is G value, I have taken G value as a 10, okay. If it is mentioned as a 10, then you should take it as a 10, or else you should take it as a 9.8 only. For our, for the easy purpose of calculation, I just took it as a 10 for now. So 200 minus 100 by 10, acceleration is 10 meter per second square. Can you do it in some 20 seconds? Yes. Now what is the tension? Tension T1 and T1 is equal to how much? Tension T2 is equal to how much? For that you should go for the free body diagram, see, or else you can assume the or you can write the formula directly. For those 5 kg, tension is acting upward T1 and its weight is acting downward, that is 50 newton. Weight of the 5 kg is 50 newton. Acceleration is upward, whole system is moving upward means 5 kg is also moving upward. So here tension T1 minus 50 newton is equal to 5 kg into acceleration. How much is the acceleration? 10. So T1 is equal to 50 plus 50, which is equal to 100 Newton. So here tension acting is 100 Newton. My question is whether this tension is greater or T2 is greater. Obviously the T2 is greater because T2 is the tension acting in this string, where this string have to lift 3 kg plus 5 kg, whereas this string is supposed to lift only 5 kg. So next go for the free body diagram of 3 kg. The force is acting on 3 kg is T2 upward, and its weight of 3 kg is 30 newton, plus tension is acting downward. Which tension? T1 is acting downward. This here is also tension, here is also tension. So plus T1. So acceleration is upward, obviously T2 is greater. T2 minus 30 plus T1 is equal to 3 into acceleration. What is acceleration? 10. So T2 is equal to 30 plus 100. T1 is 100, correct? So 130 plus 30, 160. So T2 is equal to 160 newton. T2 is equal to 160 newton, T1 is equal to 100 newton. So for this you may take 30 seconds, for this you may take some 20 seconds, let's say 20 seconds. So 30 plus 20 within 50 seconds you can calculate. Let's say 10 seconds is extra just to analyze the problem. So in 1 minute you can solve such problems. Moving to the next problem, here also you should know what is what is acceleration and what is tension. See, 2 kg and 3 kg are connected to the same string, so tension acting on this string is taken as T1. 3 kg and 5 kg are connected to the different string, so tension here is taken as T2. Now, so where the body is accelerating? Obviously, this weight is greater than this. Total weight here is 8 into 10, 80 Newton, correct? Total weight here is 20 Newton. Obviously, acceleration is downward here, acceleration is upward here. So, acceleration is equal to how much? Using the same formula, net force divided by total mass. What is the total mass? 5 plus 3 plus 2, 10. 10 is the total mass. What is the net force? The force acting on the system is total weight here and total weight here. And acceleration is due to this weight minus this weight. Am I correct? These two weights are not equal. If they are equal, then body, whole system wouldn't have accelerated. Correct? If the weight here and weight here are equal, if weight on both the sides are equal, then they would have get balanced. There is no acceleration. But now here the weight is greater, so this is accelerating this way, correct? This side is coming downward, left side is going upward. So which force is accelerating that? This weight minus this weight is the force accelerating it. So what is the weight here? So weight here is nothing but 5 plus 3 into 10. 5 plus 3 mass times a g, correct? Minus here, what is the weight here? 2 into 10. So 5 plus 3 is 8. 80 minus 20 divided by 10. This is 60. So 6 meter per second square is the acceleration. Correct? Next, what is tension T2? You can directly write the formula. If I consider this as a M1, this as a M2, and this as a M3, then T2 is equal to 2 times of, because there are two forces, this whole weight and this weight. So they are the two forces. And if M3 is 0, tension T1 will be, T2 will be 0. If M1 is 0, tension T2 will be 0. So M1 into M2, M3 into G, there is no G, there is no tension, divided by total mass. M1 plus M2 plus M3. What do you get? 2 times of M1, M1 is 2 into M3 is 5 into 10 divided by 10. Total mass is 10. 10 gets cancelled, 5, 10, 10, 20. 20 Newton is the tension acting here. T2 is equal to 20 Newton. What is the formula for tension T1? Imagine, this tension would exist only if this string stretches. When the string stretches, when this mass exists. So 2 times of M1. Why 2 times? Because there are 2 forces. And when these 2 masses stretches, that means M2 plus M3 into G divided by total mass. So how to do this? 2 into M1 is 2 into M2 plus M3 is 8 into 10 divided by 10. 10 gets cancelled. 16, 16 into 2 is 32. So 32 Newton. 32 Newton is the answer. Correct? For this sum 20 second, for this sum 30 second, for this sum, yes, again sum 20 seconds or 10 seconds. Correct? So within 1 minute you can solve this problem also if you have the practice of solving, or else you would take half an hour to solve the problem. Practice, practice, practice until it makes you perfect. Same here, acceleration is equal to how much, tension is equal to how much. See, this is a table, okay? This is a table and a pulley is connected to the table. Now, two masses M and 2M are connected through a string and that string is passing through the pulley. Let me call this as M1 and this as M2. Dear students, if this is M and this is 2M, then obviously this mass is heavier than this mass. So acceleration is downward here, acceleration is this way. We have discussed about this kind of a case. In this kind of a case, what is the acceleration? Acceleration is net force by total mass. What is total mass? Total mass here is M plus 2M. M plus 2M is how much? 3M. Okay, what is the net mass, net force? Weight of this is net force. Am I correct? So what is the weight of this? 2M into G. 2m into g is the weight of this mass. Why not the weight of this have to be considered? Because weight of this mass is acting downward, which is m into g, that is nullified with the normal force acting due to this contact. This mass is making contact with the table, so normal force is acting, that normal force is equal and opposite to the weight of it. So they get nullified. There is no contribution of weight of this mass to this acceleration. Only this weight is contributing for, or this weight is responsible for the acceleration. So acceleration is net force by total mass. So answer is 2g by 3. G is the acceleration due to gravity. Next, how do you calculate tension? Tension in the string. Okay. Now, how many forces are acting? Only one force. So, one. If M2 means this mass doesn't exist, whether this string will stretch? No, it won't stretch. If this string doesn't stretch, whether the tension would exist? No, it won't exist. So, 2M. Here, you should write M2. What about M1? If M1 is not existing, there is no tension. So, M1. And G, if there is no gravity, there is no tension. Divided by total mass. How much is total mass? 2m. Now substitute. One multiplication is not necessary. M2 is 2m into m, that is m squared into g divided by 3m. M plus 3m. M gets cancelled. 2mg divided by 3. Newton is the tension acting on the string. So this can also be done. This can be done within 10 seconds. This can be done within 30 to 40 seconds. So totally 50 to 60 seconds is enough to solve this problem when you are pro at it. Okay, moving to this, we have spoke about the similar kind. There is one inclined surface and a mass is kept there that is connected to another mass through a frictionless pulley, and this angle here is 30 degrees. What is this angle here? 90 degrees. Now what is the acceleration of this? We know acceleration is net force by total mass. What is the total mass here? 2 plus 3, 5 kg. What is the net force? One is weight of this, that is 2 into 10, 20. Another one is y component of weight of this. What is acting along this direction? That is 3 into, or you can say that if you call it as m1, m1 into g sin theta, correct? Which is the formula here for the acceleration? m2 minus m1 into g sin theta, correct? Okay, what is the weight here? m2 into g is how much? 20 minus, what is m1 into g sin theta? M1 into g sin theta is nothing but 3 into g is 30 sin 30 degree. Sin 30 degree is half. So 30 into half is 50. Divided by total mass is how much? 5. So 1 meter per second square. Am I correct? 1 meter per second square is the acceleration. What is the direction of acceleration? Acceleration is downward here, that is upward here. Ma'am, how do you know it is the way of direction of acceleration? Because this weight is greater than this component here. Okay. Now, what is the tension? Tension is equal to mass times of acceleration. Here, there are two masses. If m2 is 0, tension will be 0. If m1 is 0, tension will be 0. If this angle and this angle is 0, tension will be 0. So sin 30 plus sin 90 into g divided by total mass. What is m2? What is m2? m2 is equal to 2 kg into 3 kg. Sin 30 is half plus 1, and g is equal to how much? G is equal to 10 divided by 5. This is 3/2, and 5 ones are 5, 2s are 2, 2 gets cancelled. 18 newton. Correct. 18 Newton is the answer. Even I don't think you need more than 1 minute to solve this problem. You should be familiar with the formula. Do it until these formulas will get what? Copied in your brain. So easy way, easy method and easy problem. Similar question had appeared for 2020. This kind of question had appeared for 2020 NEET examination. So don't lose marks or don't skip this part. It is a vast concept to study, but scoring marks is very, very easy in this concept. There is no space to lose the marks when you get such questions. Okay, so let us solve more and more problems under this connected body problem.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.